Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use templates in Word. So when you open a new document in Word or open the software, you'll normally come to this page here. And at the top, it says templates. And if you go to more templates and click, it will show you a whole different range of templates. Ignore the ones at the top. These are my personal templates that I've made. And then if you go to Office down here, you'll have a range of different templates. Some of these templates are made by a different company. You can see here, designed by Moo, and also there are other ones simply designed by Microsoft. So let's go in and select this family update. The reason I'm going to select this one is because it's got quite a few elements in it that I can show you how to customize. So select this one and select create. Now, when you open it up, it can look a little bit complex sometimes, particularly because it's got all of these dotted lines. Now, actually, that's really simple and allows you to fully understand what's going on. So for most of these templates, they're not really designed to be changed and edited that much. They're really designed for you so that you can just drag and drop some text or simply change the text and some images. So I'm going to show you how to do that. And then at the end, I'll show you how to save it as your own template, so that once you've modified it, you can then use it time and time again. So the first thing to note is when you've got heading 1, heading 2, Microsoft have used something called styles. So if I click on heading 1, you can see at the top here, Word has highlighted this box, and that's because it's chosen to use a heading 1 in this style. If I click on another box, say this one, you can see that heading changes or disappears. Again, if I change this, you can see how all of that changes. And you can go ahead and select any of these styles. To add your own text, just simply delete the heading and just add your text. And if you want to modify this in any way, then simply click on it, go to Styles panel. This will give you this menu here, but as you can see, this particular heading is surrounded by blue, and that tells you that this is the element that you can modify. Click on the drop down and select modify style, and here you'll be able to edit the text, the color of the text, the size of the text, and the alignment of the text. You click on the drop down here, this is the color of your text, and you can change this to orange or whichever color you like, and then just click OK. And you can see that all of those headings that were a heading 1 in this style here have now changed to orange. Additionally, if you go to this section here, this is simply text. And again, it says normal. So this is just some normal text. To change the text, when you select it, your placeholder, you can see get started straight away, simply tap on a placeholder text. And then again, you just start typing. To go back, all you need to do is press Command or Control Z, and it will go back and restore those previous settings. If you want to change this or modify this, you can select it, go to the Home tab, and you can use all the normal tools that you would to modify this text. But it's within a table, and you can see that because of these dotted lines. Now, these are just guidelines. So if you were to print this out or if you were to save it as a PDF, these guidelines would not exist. They're just guides. But it shows you where the table boundaries are. So you can modify the table in much the same way that you would modify a table normally. So for example, if I'm hovering over this line, there you go, I can modify that if I want to, and I can modify that as well. If you want to change the pictures or images, select this one, go to Insert, Pictures, click on the drop down. You will be selecting picture from file, but I'm going to select stock images, and I will just select this image here and click Insert. And the placeholder will insert your image. You can adjust it slightly by just using these corner squares and increasing or decreasing the size. Now, you can do that with all of the images, but they may not work out exactly as you want. So we've selected this one, and then we'll select this image here and click Insert. And you can see it has not replaced that image. What you can do is select this image. You'll find that you won't be able to move it. So right click on it, go to Wrap Text, and go down to In Front of Text. You can reduce the size of it, place it where that picture is, rotate it. And you can do that with all of these pictures. You'll see here that this picture is actually behind this picture. I'll show you how to do that as well. Let's select another picture, click insert. Okay, so again, let's right click on this picture, go down to wrap text in front of text. Let's reduce the size of it, rotate it. Then select it, go to send backwards, click on the drop down and select send backwards. And you can see it's now gone behind that picture there. And you can do that with all these other images as well. So the next thing, there's this background here. If you want to change the color, select it. This is a shape. And this here is, again, a placeholder. So you can just simply change the text there. This is a shape. Go to shape format. You can change the color, shape fill. You can change all of those colors. Let's just pick a green and show you. Let's go back, because you can see on here, this is actually a gradient. So select it, go to shape format, go all the way over to format pane, go to the bucket icon, click on the drop down, and you can see here that we've got this gradient, which matches the gradient in the box. To change the colors, select these little markers, select this one, you can tell it's selected, it's got a little orange outline. Go to the colors, just select another color, select yellow, and you can see how that will affect that color. But let's just go to a blue, let's go to a purple. There we go. And that's the way that you can change that. If you want to change this line here, sometimes you can find that you'll try to click on things and nothing happens. That's usually because they're in the headers and the footers. That means that they'll be duplicated on subsequent pages, but it also means you can't edit them unless you're in the headers and footers. To access the headers and footers, double click at the top or the bottom of your page. And as you can see, we're now in the headers and footers. Everything's grayed out except for all those elements that are actually in the headers and footers. You can see now this line or this borderline is glowing. You can either select on it. If you can't select it, then it means it's not a shape and actually they've used a page border. So then go to design, page borders. And you can see that's where it has been modified. So we've got all the borders here. We've got the color. So you can change the color if you want to. Or you can just click none. If you click none, all of the borders will be taken away. And then just click OK. And you can see the borders have gone. Double click in the center of your page and you'll come back out of the headers and footers. So I'm going to speed up the video now, change some of the elements, and then I'm going to show you exactly how to save your new template so that you can then use your template over and over again. Okay, if you want to view your final document without these guidelines, click on this top left arrow here, go out to table design, up to table design, go to borders, click on the drop down and uncheck view grid lines. And it'll take all those grid lines out and you can see your final document and how it looks. Once you're happy with that, you want to save it as a template, or if you want to save it, just go up to file. If you want to just save the document, go to save. If you want to save it as a template to use in the future, go to save as template. You can then change the title. Make sure you're in templates, this file here. If not, click on the drop down and select templates. File format, again, must be Microsoft Word templates, and then click save. Let's click this, let's save this one as picture template. And then click save. And then when I go and open a new document, let's go to the home tab here. Again, I've got my templates, go to more templates. Then at the top, you've got personal. And then here you've got something called picture template. And that's where you can find your template. And if you were to click on it and click create, it would simply create this new document over again. And when you come to save it, it'll ask you to save it as a new document so it won't spoil your template. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.